everybody, welcome back. My name is Richa Mehta and I'm a licensed clinical psychologist. In today's video, we're going to understand what is depression and what we can do about it. So let's get started. Now, depression is a common mental health illness that negatively affects the way we feel, the way we think, as well as the way we behave. It can lead to significant emotional as well as physical problems that affect the way we function at work and at home. Some of the signs and symptoms of depression include sadness or low mood, which is persistent and pervasive. That means it lasts all day, nearly every day, for a minimum period of 2 weeks. And pervasive means it is present across different life situations. Other signs and symptoms include fatigue, being low on energy or tiredness throughout the day, changes in sleep and appetite, difficulty in concentrating, decision making and paying attention, loss of interest and pleasure in activities that one used to find pleasurable earlier, feelings of helplessness, hopelessness and worthlessness, usually related to oneself, one's future or the world around. And last but not the least, recurring thoughts of death or suicide. Now, depression is an umbrella term and may present itself differently and may be of different types and intensities. Some of the common types of depression include major depressive disorder, dysthymia, which is a long-lasting depression, postnatal depression, which is depression experienced right after giving birth, seasonal affective disorder, which is changes in mood associated with seasonal variation, as well as depression with psychotic features. Biochemical causes of depression include changes in the chemicals within our brain. Low levels of serotonin have seemed to contribute to depression. Having a relative who suffers from depression, especially a first-degree relative, increases the chances of developing depression. Some personality features also contribute to depression. These include having low self-esteem, being easily overwhelmed by stress, or having a pessimistic outlook in life. Vitamin deficiencies such as vitamin D, vitamin B6 and B12 often mimic symptoms of depression. The experience of stress and trauma too can significantly increase your chances of developing depression. Research shows that women are twice as likely to develop depression as compared to men. However, depression may be seen in children, young adults, older adults, as well as males too. 1 in 10 people are likely to experience a depressive episode at least once in their life, with the first episode occurring somewhere between the ages of 20 to 30 years. Psychotherapy is usually the choice of treatment, at least for depression, which is mild to moderate in intensity. Research has shown that cognitive behavior therapy is as effective, if not more effective, than medications. In CBT, your therapist will help you reformulate or work on negative thinking patterns or depressogenic schemas related to yourself, the world, as well as the future. Interpersonal psychotherapy has also shown to be effective in depression, especially when depression is arising out of stress or conflicts in interpersonal relationships. Psychodynamic psychotherapy is also a good choice for treatment, especially for long-lasting, long-standing depression or dysthymia, depressive personalities, as well as childhood traumas that contribute to depression. The second treatment option for depression is medication. When it comes to medication, there are at least 3 classes of medications that are used in the treatment of depression. The first being antidepressants, which are usually selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors or SSRIs. Your psychiatrist may also prescribe you with anti-anxiety medications or antipsychotics depending on the nature, type and symptoms of your depression. Some effective self-help strategies that one can begin at home include maintaining regular physical exercise, as that helps us release endorphins, also known as happy hormones, which help regulate our mood. Regular and consistent exposure to sunlight also helps you maintain your circadian rhythms and mood. Eating a balanced diet and maintaining adequate hydration, again, are 2 very important things in dealing with or fighting against depression. Last but not the least, learning how to cope with stress in a healthy and effective way has also shown to be effective with depression. Depression is a real illness. With proper treatment and diagnosis, a lot of people overcome it. It is a treatable condition. If you are experiencing symptoms of depression, reach out to a mental health professional today. Talk about your symptoms and request a thorough evaluation. This can be a start to address your mental health needs. Wishing you all the best on your journey of mental health.